采访的，他一看是哪儿，那屋子也不知道是哪儿啊，他拍一个外景，那证明这屋子里边谁知道是哪儿啊？这不有一个那个上个世纪的就那个间谍照片的吗？
Those kinds of landmarks make it probably a lot.
Yao Lin and his team have developed a way to look at these photographs and see what's buried underneath the ground. Maybe a part of the Great Wall has been lost. Maybe an ancient city is there. Maybe a tomb is there. So this is an incredible opportunity to give China hidden archaeological treasures.
That's the image you're shooting the computer screen.
How does it turn out? You can add elevation information, how high the mountains are, how low the valleys are, to this graphic. And then you have the ability to fly through it or walk around it and see a three-dimensional model.
When the first atomic bomb exploded,
here it goes.
You guys are above the sky. And
yes, still learning this. first time I've used it. This is actually hard to get. I've looked for U2 footage in the past. This is the first time.
The missions sometimes lasted only a single day. The longest it was ever up was for 19 days. And I believe that this makes it the world's most expensive disposable camera.
There are certain films that are shown again and again, and in America, one of them is the Iwo Jima flag raising,
yeah.
And this is probably one of the Chinese ones. Further, now you can really start to see the, go in a little closer.
So this is the first atomic bomb test site for China. So spying can be good. And the benefit of this particular spying with the U-2 spy planes, the Corona spy satellites, is that we have this wonderful treasure, these amazing photographs, this huge peace dividend that now we can use for the betterment of all the people in China.
It
shows some things in Beijing that are no longer there, including the city wall, which, as you know, was replaced by a subway terminal.
Army officer
there.
知道，东边在哪儿？ That's
the best.